Back in the studio today with me from APQ Global, I'm joined by Bart Turtelboom. Bart, welcome back.
Thank you very much, Andrew.
Taking a look today at the role of digital assets in emerging markets, I want to start off with what might seem a bit of an odd question. But do emerging markets need blockchain, for example, and digital assets?
The short answer is not really, but it would be incredibly helpful. And The reason I say not really is that emerging markets, if you look back over the past 20, 25 years, have reduced poverty very significantly, have grown significantly, have developed in many directions in a very, very positive manner. And they have done all that without blockchain. Having said all that, can blockchain be helpful in those markets? The answer to that is unequivocally yes.
And helpful how? What are some of the best applications?
We see applications in healthcare. Clearly having verifiable, strong medical information stored on the blockchain could really leapfrog medical care in quite a few emerging markets compared to the G7. But more in general, where it will be very helpful in emerging markets is that because they have much less legacy in their economy, these new technologies allow them to really jumpstart the growth in certain sectors of their economy, which is going to be incredibly powerful.
I want to get your view on security tokens. I mean, what's your thinking as far as, are they a viable way, do you reckon, when it comes to capital issuance, capital raise?
It's an incredible opportunity in our mind. And the reason for it is not that in and of itself, the security token is offering you something that a traditional bond or equity cannot offer you. Because by definition, the token is backed by a security. So from that perspective, it's not really a big innovation. But where it is a very big innovation is that it will transform the way fundraising for companies and banks is done. It will transform the corporate finance function within banks, make it much more efficient, and make it much less costly for borrowers. And that is particularly important in the context of emerging markets, where you have many smaller banks, smaller corporates, smaller governments, which really need access to capital. Historically, it's been prohibitively expensive, and this technology clearly is going to allow them to tap the market in a much more efficient manner.
Well, just on the banks themselves for a moment, what role do you see banks in emerging markets playing here?
They're going to become more important on the back of this. We're clearly coming out of what is effectively a US dollar-based global payment system. The US dollar remains the currency of last resort. And this digital innovation in finance, whether it's blockchain, whether it's coins, whether it's security tokens, is again going to allow smaller players in emerging markets to really develop their capital markets in a more efficient manner and much more quickly.
Do you believe the use of blockchain when it comes to emerging markets can produce, say, bigger gains compared to developed markets, for example?
Yes, undoubtedly so. And it again comes back to the point that because they don't have a very long-standing legacy insurance sector, because they don't have the type of banks that have been developed in the G7 and many other sectors, it clearly, in my mind, is going to allow them to build better versions of those sectors, quicker and cheaper.
Bart, good to see you. Thanks for your thoughts.
Thank you very much.